A moment, please, everybody. We have a grand surprise for you. Friends, I have the honor to announce that we have with us this evening a distinguished Irish artist and world celebrity, a beloved neighbor who is here to honor our own guest and friend, Duchess of Labour, John McCormack. This is the Duchess of Labour, John McCormack. Will you sing for us?
I certainly will, if the Duchess pleases.
Hello, John.
Oh. Hello, Kerry.
How are you? What will you sing, John?
I think I'll sing Believe Me for All These Endearing Young Charms.
Fine.
This is a lovely surprise.
Thy loveliness fade as you will, and around the dear ruin each wish of my heart would entwine itself verdantly still. Heart that has truly loved never forgets, but as truly loves on to the close, as the sunflower turns on her god when he sets, the same look which he turned when he rose.
Killarney, John. Sing Killarney, will you?
Danny boy, John. Danny boy.
Will you sing Come Back to Erin?
How about the old favorite Killarney? Will that do?
What the devil are you doing here?
I just wanted to see John McCormack sing.
See him sing?
Sure, I've never heard him except on a cracked record.
Are you sure it was the record that was cracked?
Why, Killarney, licks and feathers, emerald isle.
something. I love you.
You must not say that.
Why not? Maria, she's looking ever so sweet.
Oh, how I wish I could see her.
Hello, dear. Oh, it's all so grand, so perfect. I'm so sorry, my dear Marie will not come tonight.
Oh, you needn't worry. She was here.
Marie, here?
I'll explain to you later on. Poor soul, she had an unhappy experience in this very room.
Yes, I know.
But sure, it's your sweet self that's made her forget all that tonight. Mary and I planned another surprise for you.
For me? What is it?
I'll tell you by and by.
Oh, please.
No, 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 no. It may happen at any moment now.
Yes?
Yes.
Oh.
Sir Valentine McFarlane is expecting you.
Ah, the Duke de Montréal, I think.
Sir Valentine?
I am. And it's delighted I am to have the honor to welcome you.
Who is that?
The Duke de Montréal del Campo.
If there's any dukes about, I'll let them in. Back to the kitchen.
My nephew, Kerry Gilpellin, the Duke de Montréal.
How are you?
Delighted. Come on, don't stand here. I've been so looking forward to making your acquaintance. If you'd only been here a moment earlier, you'd have heard the most glorious voice in the world.
Drink, senor.
Thank you very much.
Just a moment, and I'll bring Maria along.
Have you just come from Spain?
No, no, from London. My mother, she is not well. I have taken her there. In the spring, I get married in London also.
Fine. Congratulations.
She did not tell you?
Who?
My bride, the Duchess of Leyva.
Don Diego, where have you come from?
Maria. A big surprise, yes?
Mm-hmm.
I get your telegram. I came very quick, huh?
I want you to meet some of the other guests. Come along.
Coming on, right now, now. One morning early as I walked forth by the margin of Loch Lynn, the sunshine dressed the trees in green and the summer bloomed again. I left the town and wandered on through fields all green and gay. And who should I meet but me Colleen and at the dawning of the
I'm sorry, Kerry.
Did you ever try to roll a cigarette with wet hands?
I only smoke cigars. Do you understand, Kerry?
I guess I do.
It's very difficult for me to explain. I have tried to tell you, but I did not know how.
Is it all arranged? Well, that's that.
Good night, girl.
Good night.